Good afternoon. Welcome to a Soil Wealth video. I'm out here at Val Micallef's property out at Bathurst. A beautiful spring day. Val's been out here about 5 years and has worked really hard to rehabilitate the farm here, and with a lot of emphasis on getting the soils right. Initially, getting the slopes right so we've got good drainage, and then he's had to spend a lot of time really trying to rebuild his soil after doing a lot of soil movement. So he's put a lot of effort into his cover crops, and one of the big challenges with cover crops is that transition between the cover crop, which is we're seeing here, through back to his cash crop. So we're going to have a little talk about how Val's doing that here. And so what I'm sitting in here is a terminated oats pea cover crop, about 3 tonne of dry matter to the hectare, so not real big and buffy, quite manageable, about a foot, 30 to 40 centimetres high, and about 3 tonnes of dry matter. So this is terminated probably about 3 weeks ago, just a glyphosate termination. And one of the important things that Val thinks about here is how he's planting not a whole paddock at once, but sequentially planting. So how much space does he have between this, his cover crop, and we'll pan in a minute across to his lettuce crop. So what we're going to do here is just start from here. Obviously this was green 3 weeks ago. It's been sprayed off. It's starting to decompose. He follows up the spray with some vertical tillage, which is what we're seeing here. So this is a whole series of discs that just basically runs over the cover crop. This has been done twice, and what it does is it incorporates and breaks up the cover crop, but it doesn't invert the soil, so you're not bringing weed seeds up, etc. And so it's a nice soft tillage option, and you can see that transition from your terminated cover crop into a bed now that's starting to get close to what you might think about planting a crop into. You'll note you can still see plenty of cover crop residue, but you know it's breaking down quite well, and you can manage the amount of breakdown of that residue that you want by changing the time period between the brown mulch over here and your cash crop, and also the number of passes you do here. So the width of, if you like, beds prepared for sowing or transplanting will vary depending on the cover crop you've got, the season you've got, and how quickly that stubble will break down, and also the risk of a wet spell coming in and disrupting your transition from the brown cover crop into your cash crop. So we've come from over in the terminated cover crop, the brown mulch, looked at how Val's been using a vertical tillage to gently incorporate that and get the seed bed ready for transplants. So it's really important that you think about how much or how many rows ahead you've got to be, because that's going to be really determined by your assessment of what the season's like in terms of how much rain you think you're going to get and whether it's going to get disrupted by wet weather. Because you need to keep that forward planting in mind. So this is quite a flexible system that Val's come up with. And it's really good in that you can just increase the amount of passes if there is a lot of residue. So you can just dial up the number of passes to manage the residue, and it's not overworking the soil too much. You know, compared to a rotary hoe, which will, you know, incorporate the biomass into the soil, but will disturb it quite a lot. This creates quite a stable soil structure so that it's not slumping when you get that rain or the irrigation. So we're just going to have a look at the transition into Val's lettuce crops. So he's been planting this paddock for some time now, and just keeping those beds ahead of where he's planting to match what he thinks the weather's going to do in terms of rainfall. And you can see here, he's basically just direct sown into it with a transplanter. There's still quite a lot of stubble on the ground. And, you know, one of the issues that might cause is the risk of sclerotinia. We're not seeing that as a major risk at the moment. But, you know, it's something that you do have to consider when you're leaving a lot of organic residues around. At the moment, this looks fine. The lettuce crop, and we will just have a look to the first planting. But, you know, just a nice system where you're going from a cover crop through into your cash crop. Okay, so we're coming across from Val's most recent planting, just across his planting sequence to one of the earlier plantings using this system that Val's developed. And you can see it's producing a pretty good crop. There's still a bit of your cover crop residue on the surface, and that's what you've got to be just a little bit careful about, particularly in spring. You don't want too much biomass on the surface because it'll slow the warming of the soil and just might slow the crop development and also that risk of sclerotinia. So you can really just sort of dial up what sort of level of crop residue you have left on the soil surface. But, you know, you can see weed control is pretty good. The soil is stable. It doesn't slump like you have following an aggressive tillage like a rotary hoe and then a rainfall. It stays really stable. The crops are doing well in it, and it's a really good example of a grower thinking about how you transition to your cover crop back into your cash crop.